Hi fam, welcome to Sacrificial Love, where we study the Bible and spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. Today, we continue with our Christmas special, summarizing the book of Luke, a chapter a day. Welcome to day 12, chapter 12. Yesterday, we summarized chapter 11. In case you missed that, you can check out the channel for the video. So welcome and stick around till the end. All the quotes or speech that I will use in this series will be from the Open English Bible. Please note that this video gives a broad summary of the chapter. I will not go into details. I encourage you to read the Gospel of Luke to get all the details that the writer documented. So, let's continue. Jesus was talking to his disciples and told them, "Be on your guard against the hypocrisy of the Pharisees. There is nothing, however covered up, which will not be uncovered, nor anything kept secret, which will not become known. So all that you have said in the dark will be heard in the light, and what you have spoken in the ear within closed doors will be proclaimed on the housetops. To you who are my friends, I say, do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but after that can do no more. I will show you of whom you should be afraid. Be afraid of him who, after killing you, has the power to fling you into hell. Yes, I say, be afraid of him. Are not 5 sparrows sold for 2 copper coins? Yet, not one of them has escaped God's notice. No, even the hairs on your head are all numbered. Do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. Everyone, I tell you, who publicly acknowledges me, the Son of Man, will also acknowledge them before God's angels. But the person who publicly disowns me will altogether be disowned before God's angels. Everyone who will say anything against the Son of Man will be forgiven, but for the person who slanders the Holy Spirit, there will be no forgiveness." Jesus continued to tell his disciples, "Whenever they take you before the synagogue courts or the magistrates or other authorities, do not be anxious as to how you will defend yourself, or what your defense will be, or what you will say. For the Holy Spirit will show you at the moment what you ought to say." Later, when speaking to a crowd, there was a man who asked Jesus to tell the brother to share the property with him. And thereafter, Jesus talked about the rich man parable. These two incidents can be found in my Parables of Jesus video, linked down in the description box below. Jesus told his disciples, "Do not be anxious about the life here, what you can get to eat, or about your body, or what you can get to wear. For life is more important than food, and the body than its clothes. Think of the ravens. They neither sow nor reap. They neither have storehouses nor barn. Yet God feeds them. And how much more precious are you than the birds?" Jesus told his disciples to seek God's kingdom first, and all these things will be added for you. Sell what belongs to you and give to charity. Make yourselves purses that will not wear out, an unlimited treasure in heaven, where no thief comes near, nor moth works ruin. For where your treasure is, there will also be your heart. Make yourselves ready, with your lamps alight, and be like the servants who are waiting for their master's return from his wedding, so that when he comes and knocks, they may open the door for him at once. Happy are those servants whom, on his return, the master will find watching. I tell you, he will make himself ready and have them take their places at the table, and will come and serve them. Whether it is late at night or early in the morning that he comes, if he finds all as it should be, then happy are they. This you do know, that had the owner of the house known at what time the thief was coming, he would have been on the watch, and he would not have let his house be broken into. You must also prepare, for when you are least expecting him, the Son of Man will come. Then Peter asked, "Master, are you telling us this parable with reference to us or to everyone?" Jesus responded, "Who then is that trustworthy steward, the careful man, who will be placed by his master over his establishment to give them their rations at that proper time? Happy will that servant be whom his master, when he comes home, will find doing this. His master, I tell you, will put him in charge of the whole of his property. Jesus then goes to explain and talk about a master leaving his home for a while and leaving his servants in charge. If, when waiting for his master, a servant thinks, my master has taken a long time coming back, and then proceeds to beat the manservants and the maidservants, and to eat and drink and get drunk, that servant's master will come on a day when he does not expect him, and at an hour of which he is unaware, and will punish him severely, and assign him his place among the untrustworthy. The servant who knows his master's wishes, and yet does not prepare and act accordingly, will receive many lashes, while one who does not know his master's wishes, but acts so as to deserve a beating, will receive but few. From everyone to whom much has been given, much will be expected, and from the man to whom much has been entrusted, the more will be demanded. We Christians should be careful to keep God's commands. We should align our will to His and live according to His will. We know what our Lord requires of us, and we should not live like we were before. Jesus then told His disciples, "I came to cast fire on earth, and what more can I wish for if it is already kindled? There is a baptism that I must undergo, and how great is my distress until it is over. Do you think I am here to bring peace on earth? No, I tell you, but to cause division. For from this time, if there are five people in a house, they will be divided, three against two, and two against three." By this, Jesus meant that He came to set the world right. From this, we learn as Christians that we should stand for truth, love, and everything that Jesus stood for. Jesus was not afraid to say what was right, even though that might have been unpopular. We should strive to live like Jesus did, and that might very well put us into conflict with relatives or friends. Thanks for taking the time out to watch this video. I appreciate it. See you tomorrow for a summary of Luke 13 and every day after that. And hey, if you are watching a couple of days or months after this series is complete, then keep on watching the rest of the videos lined up. If you like what you see, subscribe, like the video, click the notification bell so that you are informed every time I post a new video. Please feel free to share my video and let's spread the word of God together. God bless you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. May you always seek refuge in Him. See you in the next video. Bye.